So the process is socket. This socket means makes its connection between the other output devices and also with the computer. Processor socket means internally it is connected with processor and the other devices used. That is, different processor requires different sockets, and the motherboard must be chosen to suit the processor intended for use. This socket 478 Intel Pentium 4. It means many sockets are available. So with this number we can identify which type of the socket is this. So these number are for indicate the 775 Intel dual core and the Quell Duo. 754 is for AMD Athlon, and the 939 is AMD Athlon 64. Different sockets requires the different connections. So AMD means here Advanced Micro Devices. The next one is socket AM2, AMD Athlon X2. This is the indication of this name. So next is chipset, controls data flow around the computer. The definition itself tell you it is a very simple to know. It controls the flow in your computer system. So next is Northbridge. Northbridge means data flow between memory and processor, and data flow between the processor and the graphics cards. And Southbridge is controls data flow to the devices, that is USB, IDE, SATA connection and the LAN connection, and audio controls PCI slots and onboard graphics. This is divided into two parts, the chipsets are, and the Northbridge contains controls the flow between this, the memory and the processor, and also the data flow between the processor and graphics. Okay, and others, it's Southbridge, it controls the USB. These are outer flow data control. So here the IDE, it state as integrated drive electronics, and the SATA connection means the serial advanced technology attachment. Here you can use the parallel also. This is that is the different one. So now SATA connections mean serial advanced technology attachment. Next you have buses. For example, you know the buses are going to, you can travel one place to another place. As a path through which data can be sent to the different parts of the computer system means source to destination. Source means from where you have got the data or the information, it sends to other place, or you can say it as destination. So main buses are the processor and Northbridge. All memory, you have seen that all memory means data flow between the computer and the processor and the graphics. So this controls the Northbridge. And what it south controls is IDE, SATA and USB, SATA is the SATA, LAN and the audio. This contains Southbridge. So here processor and the Northbridge controls the bus by the front side, and Northbridge controls memory bus with the help of memory bus. It controls RAM connection, and then the graphics slot PC Express or AGP, it controls by graphics bus. Then you have here the internal bus. It manages the Northbridge and the Southbridge, and here you have onboard graphics. So this PC bus is controlled by this, and the PCI slot is the information controls by the PCI bus. Here power supply Power supply is nothing but you know already how it the connection should make to power supply, and a computer power supply has a number of functions. The conversion of alternating current, alternating here AC current, it can be said as AC current, so direct current also, conversion from AC current to DC current. It is very important to conversion of the AC current to DC current. And here transforms mean voltage to 240 voltage to the voltage required by the computer. For this only we need the power supply very specific here. The main voltages are 12 volt for the disk drive as they have motors. So it needs to function motors. So it is more higher voltage, and the low voltage is 3.3 and the 5 volts for the circuit boards in the computer. Uses advanced power management, this is known as APM, to allow the computers go into a standby mode. Here standby mode nothing but is when electronic device are receiving power that but are not running, means the power is on but the system is not running, it is in standby mode. Some have a switch to toggle between 240 volt supplies and 110 volt supplies. The main connections are, these are the SATA connections or many sockets are there. So main connector connects to the motherboard and supplies the 3.3 and the 5 volt supply for the board. It makes connection. This one is makes connection between motherboard and the other board. So, and next is you have the Molex connector. The connector IDE, hard drives and the optical drives. This is connection between the IDE hard drives and the optical drives. And this third one is buck connector. This is connects floppy disk. For now floppy disk are not available, so it is not used actually. The ports, ports already we have seen this ports in first diagram it is, I think. And now we are going to study this in details. So computer ports are interfaces between peripheral devices and the computer. We already know that ports, how it works, it makes connection between outer devices to the system devices. And they are mainly found at the back of the computer, but are often also built in front of the computer. New computer have all this USB ports in front of the computer. This is the ports. Mainly we are using here the mouse connection and keyboard connection. These are all connection between the monitor devices and output input Ethernet. Then ports at the front of the computer. These are the front ports are there available. Next, serial ports. Here a 9-pin port, often called COM port, COM1, COM2, etc. Mice and external modems were connected to this port. They are turquoise in color. You may know it is a color that is cyan color, or it sky blue in colors. So this is the colors of that ports. This is 9 pins means these holes you can see here. This can connect to this. The other, it makes the connection between this. So 9 pin should be available on this ports. Parallel port, 25 pin port used to connect printers, scanners, external hard disk, zip drives, etc. to the computer. It is burgundy in color. They are often called LPT ports, LP1 or LP 2, LPT 2, etc. This is in pink color. Burgundy means as same as this pink and bluishing color. So you can see here now, it connects to this. Then video ports used to connect a monitor to computer system. There are two types, VGA port. This is a 15 pin port and is blue in color. It is an analog port and it's being replaced by the DVI port. You know, the VGA means the video graphics array and the DVI means digital visual interface is given here. It may connect to this. The pin should be match here. The holes and the pins should be match. Then only it makes a connection between two devices. The projector can be connected here by the pins, by the use of these pins, and the 15 pins should be available. This is in blue in color, you can see here. Means that no conversion is necessary between the computer and the monitor, and that means that the image can be produced more quickly on the monitor. So for today, this much. Next video we will continue about the same. Thank you.